Okay, so now we can test the authentication, user authentication, because we have created two routes, register and login. And what we want to do is, once user is logged in, we wanted to return a token. So for that, so first of all, how the user is getting logged in, we are using this local authentication guard, right, which is using JWT strategy, this local strategy. And what it is doing is, it is capturing the email from the payload when you are doing a login, and it is using this particular method to validate the user with email and password. So username field for the authentication is email, and then here we are doing is get authentication user. So whatever we are returning, that will be available in the request.user. So here in the auth.controller, consider that everything is good, username password is good, we got the request.user object. If your username password is invalid, then obviously you will see a error. Okay, like if user is not found, verify password failed, then you will get appropriate HTTP exception. But if everything goes good, if everything goes fine, then you will get the request.user. And here we can create a cookies. Const cookies equal to this dot auth service dot, here we are going to create get cookies with JWT token or something like this method we are going to create, and here we can pass user.id. So this method we have to define in the auth service. What this method will do is, this method we are defining inside auth service, authentication service, and here I can say public async, and based on the user ID. So what is my token payload? Token payload contains only simple thing, which contains the user ID, and you are passing user ID as a string here. And I can just do JWT.sign const token equal to, what we can do is this dot JWT service. Now, how can we create a decode token? So I think we can simply use JWT.sign. That is a method. So what we can do is, we can use Nest.js JWT. I was thinking to use something else, but import JWT service from, I think we already imported Nest.js JWT. Yes, this will give us the method, which is JWT service, and we will inject this service inside a constructor. And we will use this JWT service to create a token with the payload. So what we need to do now is this dot JWT service dot sign. This is a method, and what all parameter does it takes? JWT dot sign, and here you can just pass the payload. Okay, this is my payload. I'm going a little slow so that we can cover everything. And here you can return authorization cookies. So what I want to do is authentication equal to dollar token. It's a dynamic expression, so put that inside a backticks. And I mean, this is like a cookies you are setting. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, I'm going to return this cookies with this token. This in the response. How we can do this? Using response dot set header, because this is express object. Here what we are doing is set, I think there is a parameter, fixed parameter for that, set cookie, and here you can set the cookies. And once you are done, you can just do response dot send user object. Okay, you already set these cookies inside a cookies header, right? So once you send the response, we can decode the cookies and we can get the token. So this is our login flow. Now, what happens like if you want to do the logout, right? Logout, for that logout, you will just clear out the cookies, right? So we can just define that method. That is going to be, first of all, use guard. Here we are going to use JWT authentication guard, because if you are doing logout, that means you are passing the token. Authentication guard, this is the first thing. We are doing post, let's say the logout, it can be simple get, and then we have method async logout, and inside logout we are just expecting the response object, response from express, that's it, is it of type response. And what we are doing is, let's import this, let's use guards, there is some typo. And then what we are doing is response.set header, we can use the same thing here. Set header here, the cookies, right? So for the cookies, we can just call the same, this dot auth service dot get cookies for logout. I mean, we just need to make that cookie null, and once that is done, we can simply say is response dot send status 200, you are logged out successfully. Okay, now this method we have to define in the auth service, and this is our auth service. Similarly, we can add another method. So inside auth service, let's move there. Here I can call the method public get cookies for logout. It's nothing but it's, you have to return a string where you just need to set the cookies null. Okay, this is done, local strategy is done, and this is the authentication guard. What this guard will do, this guard will make sure that whenever you are passing a token, that should have authorization, that should have authorization header. Right, so here you can see local authentication guard, JWT strategy. This is the important part here. What we are doing here, JWT strategy, because we have added an auth guard here. Let's import the authentication service. So this user service we have to import from the user module. The name of this user service is this, and we are inside JWT strategy. Let's import this. And then what we are doing is, we are going to call a method get by ID, because in the token, what we do, we have the user ID. So this JWT strategy is automatically going to decode your token. You can see what it is doing. JWT from request, it is extracting your authentication header from the cookies, right? It is getting the secret key, it will validate, it will decode, and then it will give you directly payload in the validate method. And here you can use the get by ID method. In the get by ID, you can say, you can validate if this user is really exist, right? So get by ID is pretty much simple. Go to your user service. Inside your user service, like get by email, I can just do the same method, get by ID. Need here is the ID is the number which we are getting. In the same, where ID equal to this, Prisma find a unique, not found exception, otherwise you will get the user. This is the helper method which we are using in JWT strategy. Okay, now everything works as expected. This is our user service. We have a couple of methods here, JWT strategy, local strategy. So everything is set up. Now I think we should be able to test the login register methods. Before that, we can also add another route in the auth controller. So we have logout, then another method we can add is, okay, get your own user data, get your own user information, right? Means once you are logged in, first of all, these routes are protected. Then when I'm saying JWT authentication guard, this is protected, this is protected, you need to pass the authentication header. here is async authenticate. This is the method, and here we are passing a request object. Okay, what we can do is, we already know if your user is already logged in, then we will get the user inside request object user. But here request should be of type request with user. Request with user is just another interface which is extending the request interface. And here user.password, I can just set null and return the user. So this way you can actually get your own user information. Simply get. Okay, so these are all APIs we have. Let's, what we can do is, now we will test all these APIs of for the authentication, login, register, logout, and a simple get user detail once after you are successfully logged in. And how we are getting this data, because we have this guard, authentication guard. This guard will extract your token coming inside a cookies, will decode it, and it is using JWT strategy. And here through this method, whatever we are returning, that will get set inside request.user, right? And the same controller, then it will go to the controller, because this is the guard. Then it will go to the controller. Request object will already have the user. You can return the user. Now you can create a post, you can create article, you can add a comment. Everywhere we have the user information inside a request object. What you need to do is, you just need to add this guard, authentication guard. Okay, let's see that in the demo in the next video. Now we can look into the demo part, like how the APIs are really working. We have this authentication controller. We can test the login, register, the logout, all these methods. Our application is running. I just have a .env with all these credentials, like the JWT secret and expiration time. Now I can start hitting the URLs. So first URL is authentication register, and it is looking for email, username, and password. I think it's username, or we can check the register DTO. So here we have email, name, and password. So it is email, name, and it is test 4. Password is test 4, and it should be HTTP post, not get. And we are able to create a user, right? So now we can try doing login, which is login, and here we are passing email and the password. Okay, what should happen when you're submitting this? It should generate the token inside the cookies in the response. You can see this is the cookies, this is the cookie authentication cookie. It is returning in the response from the login part. I mean, either you can just return the token from this payload only, or if you want the cookie based authentication system, return the token inside by setting the response cookies inside response.header.authentication. So this cookie value we are setting up. Now you can check the couple of methods. Let's say this is, we can create a duplicate of this, which is like get user. So once you are logged in, with the help of your token, you can do a lot of things. It's a HTTP get, and the API is /. And here we are getting the user. How we are getting this? Because inside the cookies, we are sending the data to the server. Can I copy this as a curl? So we already have the cookie value, right? Which is authentication. So same cookies, it is sending to the sending to the APIs again, like through this API. And then there is one more, which is logout. I think if I'm not wrong, there is a controller. So authentication is a root route. Here also you can check all the routes, what all are configured, login, logout. And logout is also HTTP post. Okay, it is saying okay. Now if I try to do get, so here you can see unauthorized. Why? Because I have already logged out. Now you can just try login, authentication login, this is HTTP post, When you do the login, we are returning things inside the cookies. Now you can actually do get user. It's a simple get. And here you are getting the user, but when you do log out, it will reset the cookies. I think this is what logout is. It should be HTTP post, I think. Okay. And I did logout. Okay. Now, if I try to get the user, the current logged in user, then you will get unauthorized, right? So our APIs really works. Our JWT strategy and local JWT strategy and guards all are working, and we are getting the token inside this. So here, if you look into this authentication, we have JWT strategy. Here I was trying to print the value of the cookies that is coming from the client side. So here we captured that cookie as authorization header, and then we are validating it against the secret or key. If everything is fine, it will decode the payload, and from the payload we have the user ID. So it will get the user ID, and it will set that user ID in the request.user object. Okay, so this is the authentication and authorization, simple authentication, I think, which is using couple of user services. Inside this we have user services where we have defined a couple of methods, get by ID, get by email, create and all. Now we are going to write posts. So posts, like if you wanted to create a new post, so what I will do is I will create a new folder, posts. We have already seen the demo of the application, how it is going to, how it is using the Prisma. Now we will also see the same thing inside some services of the post, like post service. So this is post DT. Now we can create all the methods. Posts.controller.ts. Another one is posts.service.ts. Okay, so we have service controllers and all. Now inside post service, we can focus on the post service, because this is the service which is going to create the posts and attach the category. So we'll go to the post service. We'll just bootstrap the post service, and then we will write all the methods. So this is our post service, Prisma service we are injecting here. We'll import that injectable, get it from the Nest.js. Okay, now we are defining the methods like create post, update post, delete post, right? So similarly, we have async create post method. So inside this, now what you are going to pass on all the routes, additional routes, you will always pass the DTO, like this is the post DTO. And in every route, you will be passing user object, because now we have a user object inside a request. So before, either you create a post, category, comment, article, you can actually pass the reference of the user. This is from the Prisma client, and here it is talking about create post DTO, so that we can simply create. I think we should already have. So create post DTO. Here we can define a file name. Create post. So inside post, what all things we have? Title, content, and category IDs. This is what we have inside our DTO. So based on that, we will receive the payload, like the title, content, and category IDs, which is optional. Okay. So here we are passing create post.dto. You'll import what is there. And here we are inside a create post. So this is the post controller. Inside post controller, what we will do is we can just define, okay, what will be the root route, which is annotation controllers. So this is service. Okay, so it's like we are inside a post service. We can create post, Okay, so here what we need to do is we need to create a post. So return this dot Prisma service dot post dot create. This is the method we have, and what we are doing is here you just pass all the data. Inside data we have title, post dot title, content, post dot content, author. Author should be a connection here, right? So for author we are using connect utility. ID will be user.id. This is how we actually connect to connect the relationship. So here we are getting title, content. I think everything is covered here. Title, content. Why it is complaining? Okay, we also need to specify select. Okay, this is after this what we wanted to select. So this is create, and we are passing all the data we wanted to put inside this, and then we can just say it's include category, so that is true. I need to see what is the problem here. Title, content, post.content, does it exist? Yes, so here inside the post we do have a title and the content. I think we did some mistake in the post schema. Okay, you can see there is a typo. And to fix this, we need to do the two things here. We need to run the migration and we need to generate an npm run migrate. Why migrate? Because we are changing the column name, so we need a migration. Npm run generate because we wanted to update the Prisma client. So both will work in the same way. Here the VR generate updated the Prisma client. So now we should not see that warning here in our code. Yes, it has gone. So this is a create post. Similarly, you will do update post, delete post. All those APIs we can write. So if you, let's say this is a create post, I can also think about here like create post, update post, delete post. This is our first method inside post service. Now you just need to plug this in with the post controller and you have to write it. So here let's say I wanted to update a post. Right, in the update post, we will just get the post update post DTO. So inside update post DTO, and we will be passing the route parameter. Route parameter is the ID to which you wanted to update. So this is inside DTO, I can specify update post DTO. You can import through the same file. I mean, you can create a totally separate DTO file. One is for create, one is for update. Quick fix. Now inside we are getting the user and we are getting the post. So post will give us all the required property you wanted to update. So this dot post service dot create. So similarly, there is an update and update based on data. So this is the data we are passing. And we have to update based on some condition where ID equal to the ID which we are passing. So here we need two things, update post, post and the ID. ID is of type number. So update the data. Update the post where ID equal to this update post. Similarly, there is another method we can have is the delete post. You also need to handle the catch here, like if something goes wrong, So here delete post, we just need the ID. This dot service dot, here we will just define delete where ID equal to this. We are not returning any data. We are not saving any data, right? So this is a simple delete. There can be try catch. You can put like if record doesn't exist, right? Then it will return record not exist, some kind of exception. So either you can check first if this record already exists with this ID. So here we can just check this dot validate record. Validate record and ID, and here I can just say passing validate record ID. Here we can do all the checks. Okay, let's say const post equal to await this dot prisma service dot find unique prisma service dot post dot find one unique. And find based on what, where condition, where this is equal to this. So if post is not there, then we can just return or throw simply new not found exception. You can customize these kind of exceptions. Post not found. If everything is good, so we can return the post. So the same thing, you can actually call this from all the places. We have to put await. What is this? Let's import this. So we can validate this record. Okay, this record exists, like with before update, before delete, we can do this. Rest we don't need to do anything. Await. So we need to put await because this looks like promise. Here, yes, we need to put await because it is returning promise. Await, return await this, return await this. Not found exception. Sometimes it took a lot of time for to IntelliSense a module. Await, return await this, delete post, update post, create post. And we are done. The Prisma generate and Prisma migrate, because that automatically changes the database table constraint, or that also changes the Prisma client type definitions, because we are generating the Prisma client type definition here inside Prisma index.d.ts. And here we can see user, post, tag, category, everything. So this is all about how you can do the integration with the Nest.js. I will be covering Nest.js with the Prisma more in the coming set of videos, but for now this is enough, like how you can use Prisma with the Nest.js application. You just need to inject the Nest.js service, sorry, Prisma service, and this dot Prisma service dot your model name, user, post, entity, user, post, comment, article, dot find one, find unique, update one, update many, all these methods you can access. Okay, that's all guys. Thanks everyone.